days when everything seems so much clearer. Women in white who knew what their lives held in store. Where are they now? Those women who stared from the mirror. My moon and my stars and my ocean. We can never go back to before. We can never go back to before.
We can never go back to before. I don't think many people in this room would want to. Who wants to go back to before? I certainly would not want to go back to before. I think the question before us this morning, though, is feminism still relevant as we're trying to figure out how to move forward? So I'm not going to ask you to raise your hands because I think that creates a little bit too much peer pressure. But just check in with yourself. Would you call yourself a feminist today, out loud, not just inside? Yes, Shelly, who cares about the peer pressure? Shelly's like, argh. Okay, just internally. And I want to read before I get too far into this conversation, I want to read you the words of Bell Hooks, who's an American author, feminist, social activist, definitely out of the closet feminist. She wrote, Feminism is for Everybody in the year 2000. And we're going to hear from Adichie, I'm all of a sudden spacing out her name, Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie, who wrote a book with the same title, Feminism is for Everybody, just a few years ago. But this is bell hooks. Imagine living in a world where there is no domination, where females and males are not alike or even always equal, but where a vision of mutuality is the ethos shaping our interactions. Imagine living in a world where we can all be who we are, a world of peace and possibility. Feminist revolution alone will not create such a world. We need to end racism, class elitism, imperialism, but it will make it possible for us to be self-actualized females and males, able to create beloved community, to live together, realizing our dreams of freedom and justice, living the truth that we are all created equal. Come closer. See how feminism can touch and change your life and all our lives. Come closer and know firsthand what feminist movement is all about. Come closer and you will see feminism is for everybody. You may have heard me say before, and it's still true, that I would not have chosen to be born a woman in any other time or in any other place than this country. At the time I was born, I have a hard time imagining living without the freedoms that I have. And I'm prepared to struggle today to protect those freedoms together. And there's information out in the foyer this morning, or people out in the foyer if you want to sign up for to join with women who are organizing in this congregation right now. So I also love learning, though, about women from other parts of the world, women who come from backgrounds that are different than mine, who feel the same way. So thus, Chimamanda Ngozi Adichie will be joining us this morning. So listening to Adichie made me think back in my own life to where I was when I was 14. And I was living alone with my mother because my father had left our family. I'm telling you this story for a reason. He had had an affair and left, and I'm the youngest of three. My sister and brother had gone off, were out of the house. And I was lucky enough to go to an all-girls high school that was very affirming of women's rights and feminism and taught us all that women should have opportunity, the same opportunity as boys to any career, any future that they wanted. But what I realized looking back is that even if in my head I was a feminist, in my heart, there was a lag or a lapse. There was a gap between what my head knew and my heart knew, and it would take years to do the healing work that adolescent girl needed to do to know that I could be whole and complete in the world without a man after losing my father in that way. So in honor of myself and Adichie at 14, I looked up some definitions of feminism. And some of them are what you would expect to hear. The theory of the political, economic, and social equality of the sexes, or organized activity being the key, thus the sign up for women out in the foyer, organized activity on behalf of women's rights and interests. And then there were some other more subtle definitions, perhaps a little bit more demanding definitions. I liked this one. Feminism isn't about individual women managing to overcome the system on their own without challenging the system itself. Instead, it's about fighting for the equal rights of every last woman and girl, and to do that requires the power of collective commitment and action. Some of the definitions were a little creative. Let's see what you think of this one. Feminism is the difference between one woman trying to stop her husband beating her and a whole village full of women banding together to shame an abusive husband by beating metal cooking pans outside his door, holding him accountable in the eyes of the community. Yeah, I like that one. Thank you, I like that one. And a last favorite, feminism is the radical notion that women are people. Which might surprise some of us this morning, or might seem superfluous in 2019, that we still need to say that feminism is the radical notion that women are people. But the truth is, many girls still today become aware early in life that although, of course, we are people, we're considered by others to be somehow an inferior type of person. We learn this directly. We learn it indirectly. It's why I was thinking earlier, I wish I knew all the women's stories in this sanctuary, because there's a burden women, we tend to take upon ourselves as if we have this obligation to serve in ways that men don't. And Adichie is no exception. You hear that last line? I often make the mistake of thinking that something is obvious to me as just as obvious to everyone else. So for some people, they're like, of course I'm a feminist. Why is she talking about something like so But the fact that feminism is for everybody is not obvious. The fact that feminism is for men and women, the fact that feminism is for old and young, the fact that feminism is for Muslims and Jews and Christians is not obvious yet. And to the contrary, being a feminist is not something people proudly proclaim. Women or men, and not just in Africa, but also in the United States of America, even in Tulsa, even here at All Souls. Our own communications manager, Bonita James, wrote the introduction to our year-long blog that I hope many of you will contribute to, our year-long blog series, which she called On the F Word. This is edited only slightly. This is Bonita's story. I remember buying my first feminist journal from the only place in my small town I could get any type of alternative media, Hastings. Tucked on the bottom half of the magazine rack in the far back row next to Advocate was Bust. I don't remember how old I was, but I was old enough to drive, and I felt incredibly alone in the middle of America. On the cover, there was Gloria Steinem in all her glory with the F-word feminism bedazzled on her shirt, standing strong in her Wonder Woman pose. I bought the magazine with my head down and stuffed it into my bag with shame and secrecy. I read every word of that magazine, read every ad, and fell in love with Kathleen Hanna. Through that issue, I discovered one of my all-time favorite bands, the Tigre, which led to my first crush on a girl with a mustache. But my Bust magazine stayed hidden in my room. I was so scared that someone would find out that I was interested in this thing called feminism. Looking back, I was probably more afraid of being called a feminist than I was of being outed as gay. So we avoid the F word sort of the same way we avoid talking about taxes here in Oklahoma. Or we modify it. We make it conditional. I'm a feminist, but I really like men. I'm a feminist, but I'm not angry all the time. So part of this morning, besides Women's History Month, our theme this month is letting go. So part of this morning is about what negative baggage do each of us need to let go of to be able to more fully embrace this idea that we're all created equal, and when we can really start to see each other as equal, that leads to seeing all of us as equal, right? Any ism we can break through allows us to open our heart more widely to more and more people. And in thinking about it this month, I realized there are many reasons why people resist and reject this word. For some people, it's obvious. It upsets the patriarchy, the power of white males in the United States of America. So it's obvious why some people who reject the ideas presented by feminist thinkers. I realized, and this has impacted me, that it's another reason is that because the second wave of feminism, they call it, in the 70s and 80s, really focused mostly or only on white women. And so there's been a rejection of the movement because it excluded women of color. But back to that idea of just it being too radical for some people. Francia told that great story in Germany of how she wasn't afforded the respect or the full rank, really, of being a minister just because she was a woman. And I remembered in preparing this 10 years ago in California, of all places, where I did my internship, a retired Protestant minister, male minister, looking me in the eyes and saying, well, none of Jesus' disciples were ministers, so I just don't see why a woman could, would, or should be a minister in a church today. And I don't know how many of you heard Marlon's sermon last week, but I would love for that man to listen to Marlon's sermon and educate himself about the fact, as Marlon taught last week, that that the first disciples, the first deacons, the first apostles were women, and that Jesus had so many women surrounding him and empowered them to lead. So then maybe the biggest surprise is that for some people today, feminism isn't progressive enough of an idea. Jeff Beeson is a member here and the father of two young boys, and he gave me permission to share some of his thinking. So this is his voice. I'm not sure right now, he said, that I do, in fact, identify as a feminist. I can somewhat describe my position as a gender liberationist or a gender egalitarian, but that doesn't really roll off the tongue. But I'm looking for an expression of something that includes feminism, masculism, transism, agenderism, and the freedom of gender expressions across the board. Some people say that feminism encompasses the overall aim, but the name itself is exclusive rather than inclusive, and I find it problematic. And then he talks about how he loved bell hooks' statement that I read before. Imagine living in a world where there is no domination, where females and males are not alike or even always equal, but where a vision of mutuality is the ethos shaping our interactions. Imagine living in a world where we can all be who we are, a world of peace and possibility. And to the end of creating that world, he said, I find myself working constantly to combat the gender normative and patriarchal narrative and help my sons see it. When my sons and I go through the drive-thru and the attendant asks if they would like a boy toy or a girl toy, I can often proudly hear shouted from the back, there is no such thing as a boy toy or a girl toy. Or they'll come home from school and relate arguments with classmates about whether or not purple is a girl color. And they'll proudly proclaim that there's no such thing as a girl color and they can like purple if they want to. When we watch television, Jeff says, we always try to point out the strong female characters that we find, and we look for examples of male characters relying on and following the female characters. We look for examples and moments of feminine strength and male vulnerability. Fortunately, these examples are more and more common. And then we also try to combat the binary narrative, he says. We talk about sometimes how people born as boys feel like girls, and people born as girls feel like boys, and that it's okay for anyone to feel however they want and be whoever they want. He tells a story about his son, Ronan, having somebody in his class who's exploring their gender identity. He calls him Joe, them Joe, to protect their identity. And Ronan came home one day telling his dad, some days Joe is a girl, and some days Joe is a boy. Or one day he came home and said, Joe got mad at me today because I said they were a boy, but I didn't know they were a girl today. And Jeff, this is so beautiful. It's amazing to watch both my sons learn and navigate, he says, ideas that I didn't really even conceive of until well into my adulthood. But there's a danger to all of this, he continues. As I teach these things to my sons, the thing about teaching young men and women to combat gender norms is that they will also face retaliation. I know that I'm setting my sons up to be ostracized. Children are cruel. And instead of teaching my sons how to keep their heads down and safe, I'm putting their necks out there. And they have no idea the danger of these ideas. They'll be mocked by their peers for their views. They'll come from both men and women. The mocking from men will do the lesser damage, as they will already have built up a shell against male-on-male bullying. But the young women in their life that mock them and make fun of them for not being real men is going to confuse and hurt so much more. It did for me. On top of that, I expect each one of them to come home one day terrified or beaten up because they got cornered in a locker room by a real man. My prayer is that it will be less severe for them than it was for me, that they'll have more peers and authority figures in their lives that will tell them it's okay and will lift them back up. We've come a long way, but we're not far enough along that I think they're safe. So I'll let you decide for yourself whether you think Jeff is a feminist or not. And I have a question for you. If you decided to be a feminist today, or a gender liberationist, what would you have to let go of? What would you have to let go of? Physical strength is no longer a necessary attribute for our survival. What the world needs now are creative, innovative, compassionate, intelligent people to lead. We need leaders with new strengths and new ideas in our communities. I recently read in Tricycle magazine, a Buddhist journal, this feminism is coming back as a label to be proud of for both men and women. Both Barack Obama and Justin Trudeau call themselves feminists. Feminism's comeback is especially true as the movement is becoming more inclusive and more intersectional, taking into account the unique experiences of women of color, transgender women, and low-income women. It's not too late to be a feminist. In fact, I would argue that this is the perfect time in history to become a feminist, and an important time to reflect and consider and let go of whatever's in your way of fully embracing this idea that we are truly all created equal. In talking to people this month, these are some of the things I heard that people would have to let go of. I would have to let go of thinking I won't be a real man. I would have to let go of thinking that being a feminist means I can't be feminine. I would have to let go of the guilt for my past actions. I would have to let go of the idea that women are naturally feminists and men are naturally misogynists. I'd have to let go of thinking I'm free when my sisters around the world and right here in Tulsa are not. I'd have to let go of thinking that feminism is about anger when really it's about love. In the words of bell hooks, if women and men want to know love, we have to yearn for feminism. There can be no love when there is domination. With that awareness comes the understanding that love has the power to transform us, giving us the strength to oppose any and all domination. To choose feminism, then, is to choose love. So is feminism just for women? Yeah. What, is feminism just for women? Yeah. No, feminism is for women and men because real masculinity does not equal patriarchy. You got that? Real masculinity does not equal patriarchy. Is feminism just for white women? No, feminism is for all women, white women and black women and brown women, for rich women and poor women. Feminism is definitely for progressives who can push the envelope even further past the gender binary. This is a big sentence. It was fun to write, though. As we deconstruct the intellectual and habitual foundations of a patriarchal system that imprisons all of us. You got it? Is feminism just for grown-ups? No, feminism is for children, for girls and boys and trans children, for children of all colors and creeds and classes. And feminism is for people of all faiths. It's important to hold. We are holding our Muslim brothers and sisters today, people of all faiths, Christian, Jewish, Muslim, and more. As Adichie says, we can do better. We must do better. Culture doesn't make us. We transform from the inside. We make culture. And feminism today is for a future filled with freedom and love for everybody all over this incredibly beautiful and struggling and suffering planet. Thank you for listening to me. Thank you, Breath of Life.
Here we go. Woo! What you We're so happy you're visiting with us online today. We love connecting with people all across the country and around the world, sharing our powerful message of love beyond belief.
There's something new happening here. You can now join All Souls as a virtual member. Our virtual membership is designed for friends who live outside of Tulsa, Oklahoma, and who want to engage with All Souls in a meaningful way.
You can be part of an expanding family, a global family, really, wherever you are. If you live in Oklahoma,
Ohio,
or Orange County, California,
Canada,
or Cameroon. By becoming a virtual member, you'll be able to deepen your connections with members and friends here in Tulsa and with members wherever you are.
Each week, you'll receive special All Souls content tailored for you, our virtual members. Virtual members have access to pastoral care, to personal prayers, and also receive invitations to exclusive web events.
You can learn more, and if you're ready, you can become a virtual member today by visiting allsoulschurch.org/virtual membership.
We're grateful our ministries are having a positive impact on your life, and we want to share the good news of love beyond belief with more and more people. So no matter what, we need your support to keep this ministry growing and thriving. So please consider making a gift today. You can do so by texting
LOVEBB for Love Beyond Belief to 73256 or simply visit our website. You are a blessing in our lives. May you be blessed.
And be a blessing.